All of a sudden, I come up out of my body, I turn over, and I'm looking down upon myself, and I float away, and I come back, and I come back into my body. Something was going on. What I didn't know was what side it was on. Was it from the light or from the dark? So I was born into a secular Jewish home. We celebrated Passover, Sukkot, Hanukkah, and I remember going to synagogue a lot. The prayers were done in Hebrew. We didn't really understand what we were saying. Baruch Atah Adonai Eloheinu Melech HaOlam, and we would be like, this is what we do as Jewish people, but what are we actually saying? I remember, you know, being in temple and just sitting there listening to the rabbi and just looking up at the stained glass windows, and I didn't feel God in the congregation. I felt him personally. And so growing up in a Jewish family, there's a lot of pressure on success, achievement, good grades, good school, good job. And so as I left for high school and I left for college, you know, I had to pick a major and I went to a school for business, although all I really wanted to do was sing, dance, and do sports. But I feel that this is what I have to do. And it really tore me up. I'm not succeeding here, I'm not doing well. Not only did I feel like I was disappointing my parents, I was disappointing myself. I've had it. I'm out of here. And I left college. So that whole experience over those years of trying and effort and failing just primed me for a headfirst dive into New Age spirituality. So here I am meditating, finding the silence and the peace and emptying my mind. And the problem with that is that in an empty space, something's gonna come in. I would start to feel this oppression, this sense of odd control nudging me into certain directions. Go here, go there, pick that up, turn around and walk back. And I felt like if I didn't do what that presence or that voice was telling me to do, that something bad would happen to me. I even had an outer body experience once where here I am laying on my bed, and all of a sudden I come up out of my body, I turn over, and I'm looking down upon myself, and I float away, and I come back into my body. Something was going on. What I didn't know was what side it was on. Was it from the light or from the dark? And come to find out that sure enough, it was from the dark. I was doing everything I can to put on a happy face and not let anybody know what was happening inside of me, but people knew. So my wife started noticing that I was going into depression. I remember one day, lying on the floor in my wife's arms, just bawling my eyes out. And I'm crying and I'm looking up at her and I'm saying, I'm sorry. I have no idea what I'm doing. I've spent 20 years in an effort to become more spiritual, successful, enlightened, and I have nothing to show for it. I'm empty. And to be honest, I really didn't have much strength or effort to live anymore. But I looked at my beautiful wife, and I looked at my beautiful children, and I said, wow, there's no way I could take myself out of this world, even though I have no desire to live. I'm tired of pretending like I'm some sort of advanced spiritual being, when deep down inside I knew that I was broken. And I thought, what's wrong with me? I've dedicated the last 10 years, 12 years, 15 years to meditation and spiritual practice, positive affirmations, and I have nothing to show for it. So here I am, I'm going to the gym, and this really tall guy comes up to me, and he looks at me and he says, you know, I've been watching you, and you know, we're about the same age, and I just wanna know, what do you eat? And I said, okay, well, you know, you don't really wanna know what I eat. And he's like, what, burgers and pizza and whatever you want? And I was like, no. I'm like, well, I eat a plant-based diet. So the next day I come in, and I look at this guy, and he's over at the other side of the gym, and I'm like, you know, I kind of feel drawn to this guy. I want to go ask him a question. So I walk over and ask him. I said, hey, what do you do, by the way? And he goes, I'm a pastor. And for some reason, that sparked something in me. And so I started asking him these questions, and he'd give me these really concise answers. And then I'd go home, And I'd say, you know, honey, I had this interesting experience at the gym, and we talked a little bit about Christianity. We talked a little bit about, you know, him being a pastor and what he does. So one of the biggest things that my wife was having trouble with was, how can she be Jewish and believe in Jesus? Because everything that she'd heard up at that time was, Jesus is not for the Jews. And so she was wrestling with that, and she came upon videos from One for Israel. Videos, testimony videos of Jewish people coming to faith in Jesus. And my son would come home, he's like, yeah, I just had these great experiences about learning about Jesus. And we were like, something's going on here. And so I went back to the gym and I saw this other guy on the other side of the gym. I was like, he has something in him that I want. He looks happy. There's a spark in him. So I went over and I introduced myself and he goes, can I pray for you? And I said, okay, why not? And at the end of the prayer, he says, in Jesus' name. Day after day, I kept coming back to the gym and I had this desire to look for this guy. And I would go up for him specifically for prayer. And every day I said, in Jesus' name, I started to feel like something was happening. And what I realized over time was that peace, it wasn't the absence of something. It was the presence of something. Or should I say, someone. When I heard the name Jesus, when I heard the name Yeshua, when I started to study and read about him, when my family went out into the world, had experiences that were related to Jesus, and we came home, we felt life. For the first time, we felt life. And it was at that moment that my wife and I, we got on our knees and we gave our lives to Jesus, Yeshua. And I knew that Jesus was the only one. The only one. And it was at that moment, this energy went through me that I'd never felt before. The depression, the anxiety, the fear, chronic issues that I'd been carrying with me my entire life, in one moment, were gone. So here I am now believing in Jesus and following Jesus and, you know, a new man, and I gotta go face my parents again. We go down and visit them and we just, you know, said, hey, you know, we have found new life in Jesus. And my mom was like, you know, that's nice for you, but why can't you just be Jewish? You know, why can't you just stay Jewish? And I'm like, Mom, if you only knew that following Jesus was the most Jewish thing you could ever do.